Today we're tuning this 1993 Eagle Talon TSI. It is a link ECU car. It's got a different turbocharger on it, a couple other odds and ends we'll go over here in a second, but gonna be a neat car. I love these things, so check it out. Here's this 1G. It is a 93 TSI car. It has an FP manifold, FP black turbocharger. It's still internally gated and recirc, so no open dump, no external wastegate. It's kind of nice, kind of cool. Something a little bit different you don't see very often. Hopefully we don't have any boost creep issues. That would be the big concern there, but yeah, if that's okay, then never a problem with that style setup. Unless, you know, we run into a gate spring problem as well. I guess there's a couple potential issues there. We'll see how it goes once we get rolling on it. But it's got a, you know, front mount, a tile bypass valve with, you know, no tube on it kind of thing. But, yeah. Pretty straightforward setup. It's got different cam gears in it, I see. I'm assuming, I think he said this thing has different camshafts, but I do not remember what they are. Stock intake manifold still. Car's been painted. The color looks so good on this thing. It's a leather interior car too, which is pretty neat. Don't see too many of those for sure. Check it out. It's, you know, your normal. Got some time on it, but it's not in bad shape. One more unique thing about this car is it has a it's a link ECU, not ESM link, DSM link, right? Or ECM link, I guess, whichever name you want to call that. This has an actual standalone link ECU in it, which is pretty oddball for this kind of thing. Usually these would have DSM link on, but the link ECU is a great standalone option. It is a plug and play for these cars. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna tag into the link ECU and get programming this thing and see what kind of power we can make. It's still in pump gas. He wants to make 400 wheel with it, which, as long as we have adequate control of the boost, should be pretty doable. So, I'm gonna dive into it. Just got wrapped up with this DSM, made 402 horsepower, 390 foot-pounds of torque. You can see the torque curve's pretty, it falls off pretty bad. It tells me a couple things. It's on a stock intake manifold with a charger that spools relatively late. The stock manifold, the charger's really just starting to work as the manifold's running out of steam. That's why the power curve looks the way it does. That and a camshaft combination too. The thing needs more camshaft, but but yeah, all in all, good runner. We were able to meet his goals, which is cool. I was a little worried we weren't going to be able to get there. It took right around 30 pounds to get to 400, so which is, you know, not uncommon. Just was hoping to be able to do it on a little bit less, but with the combination the way it is, that's just what we had to do to get there. So, but yeah, that's it for this one. I'm gonna get it off of here and get ready for the next. So.